Hey guys, welcome to part 6 of our Endless Runner tutorial series. Today, we'll make the character lose when hitting an obstacle and show a game over screen. Currently, nothing happens when we hit an obstacle. But in this video, when the character hits an obstacle, they'll lose and a game over screen will appear. We'll start with a simple game over screen and later add a score system and display the final score and high score in upcoming tutorials, as seen in this image. Let's begin. First, in Unreal Engine, open the BP_runner-character blueprint and create a new function called death. In the graph, drag and drop the character movement from the components tab and add disable movement, then disable input. Also, add a set simulate physics node, ensure it targets mesh, not capsule component, and tick the simulate option. Next, add a get player controller node, and from it, add a set show mouse cursor node and tick the box. Connect the execution pins, select the player controller and the set show mouse cursor node, then drag them away from the other nodes. Compile and save. Now, open the obstacle blocker blueprint and in the viewport from the components tab, add a box collision. Adjust its size so that more than half of it is inside the cube and a little bit is outside. In the event graph from event actor begin overlap, add a cast to BP_runner-character node. And as runner character, add an is sliding node. From the is sliding node, add a branch node. Connect the execution pins and add the death function as runner character and connect it to the false pin of the branch node. Then add a delay node and set the value to 1 second. After that, add a set game paused node and tick it. Select all those nodes except branch is sliding and event actor begin overlap, copy them, and open the obstacle underscore wall blueprint. In the event graph, paste the nodes and connect the cast to runner character pins to event actor begin overlap, and connect the death function's execution pin to the cast to character. In the viewport, add a box collision to the obstacle underscore wall blueprint and change its size to 3 in all axes and bring it up a bit in the Z-axis. In the content browser, create a new folder called HUD. Open it and right-click in the User Interface section, select Widget Blueprint, then User Widget, and name it GameOver_UI. Open it, and from the Palette tab, add a canvas panel, and then add a background blur to the canvas panel. Select the background blur, and in the Details panel, set the anchor to full screen and change the values to 0. Now, add a text element, set the anchor to the top, and reset the position in the Details panel. Adjust the position as you wish. Change the text to Game Over, increase the font size around 110 or 115, and change the color to red. From the Palette tab, add a button named Restart_BTN. Set the anchor to the center of the canvas panel and adjust the size and position. Duplicate the button, move it below the other button, and name it Exit_BTN. Drag and drop text from the Palette tab to the buttons, and change the text to Restart and Exit for both buttons. Select the background blur and set the strength to 5.
Now, go to the graph by clicking on the top right corner. Select the Restart underscore BTN, and in the Details panel, click on Clicked to add an event. Do the same for the Exit underscore BTN. From the Exit underscore BTN execution pin, add an Execute Console command node and set the command to Exit. Copy the node and paste it on the Restart underscore BTN. Connect the execution pins and change the command to Restart Level. Next, go to the BP underscore runner character, and in the death function, add a create widget node. From the drop-down menu, select GameOver underscore UI. Then from the return value, add the add to viewport node, connect the execution pins. Select the skeletal mesh and change the collision type to Ragdoll. If you're using a custom character, open the folder where your character is. And if your character doesn't have a physics asset, right-click on the skeletal mesh. Select Create, Physics Asset, then Create and Assign. Keep the values to default and click Create. Save it. Open the level, press Play, and you'll see when the character hits an obstacle, it falls down with Ragdoll physics, and a game over screen appears. Here you can restart the game or exit it. This UI is temporary, and we'll improve it in upcoming tutorials. If you encounter any errors or need help, you can contact me via email or Discord. You can find the details in the description. That's it for today's video. I hope you find this tutorial helpful. Stay tuned for more exciting content. If you enjoyed the video, remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more amazing tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.